During the COVID-19 pandemic, scammers may try to take advantage of you. They might get in touch by phone, email, postal mail, text, or social media. Protect your money and your identity. Don't share personal information like your bank account number, social security number, or date of birth. Learn how to recognize and report a COVID vaccine scam and other types of coronavirus scams. Your vaccination card has information on it, including your full name, date of birth, where you got your vaccine, and the dates you got it. When you post it to Facebook, Instagram, or to some other social media platform, you may be handing valuable information over to someone who could use it for identity theft. While we work together to slow the spread of coronavirus disease, some people might be tempted to buy or use questionable products that claim to help diagnose, treat, cure, and even prevent COVID-19. These fraudulent products that claim to cure, treat, or prevent COVID-19 haven't been evaluated by the government for safety and effectiveness and might be dangerous to you and your family. It's been also seen unauthorized fraudulent test kits for COVID-19 being sold online. You will risk unknowingly spreading COVID-19 or not getting treated appropriately if you use an unauthorized test. When you decide to support a cause you care about, you want your donation to count. Doing some research and planning your giving can help ensure your donations get where they'll do good. If someone wants donations in cash, by gift card, or by wiring money, don't do it. That's how scammers ask you to pay. To be safer, pay by credit card or check. It's a good practice to keep a record of all donations and review your statements closely to make sure you're only charged the amount you agreed to donate and that you're not signed up to make a recurring donation. Don't let anyone rush you into making a donation. That's something scammers do. Some scammers try to trick you into paying them by thanking you for a donation that you never made. Scammers can change caller ID to make a call look like it's from a local area code. Scammers make lots of vague and sentimental claims but give no specifics about how your donation will be used. Some scammers use names that sound a lot like the names of real charities. This is one reason it pays to do some research before giving. Scammers pretend to be from COVID-19 Funeral Assistance Program and call to offer program registration to family members of people who have died from COVID-19. In this way, the scammers can steal the family members' social security numbers and other forms of identification. Please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe.